We're back again. Well, we'd like to thank that third part sponsor, Google, and our favorite water, Pellegrino. So what do I have for advice for people wanting to be in the business? You need to be a little bit full of shit, like I am, clearly. We don't have sponsorship like that, but we say we do, and then maybe they, next thing you know, you have the sponsor. I've actually always believed you need to puff up the balloon a little bit more than the reality that's there. Steve Jobs always was told that he has this thing, it's called like the irrational field around him, where he pretends something's a little more real than it really was, but then he moved everybody to fill that void and actually create that product, and he did an amazing job. So while I joke a little bit that it's BS, I do think you need to create some vision that you believe in and what you think you could achieve, and push the reality that that's what it will be and is, and get everyone to fill that void, and then it becomes reality. Getting a place in Nashville and talking about it like it was real and happening allowed certain things to then move forward. And then when you talk to an investor, that you got the building, and you get the building, and then you got the investor, and it just it becomes this momentum that you kind of need. And so I've always felt you got to push the envelope. I like to say you puff the balloon a little bit bigger. When I was managing this band Swamp Thing way back before starting the Knitting Factory, we would come and play in New York, and we would tell everyone in New York that this band's super popular in Wisconsin. Then we come back from tour after getting some gigs in New York that maybe 10 people showed up, sadly, and come back to the Wisconsin promoters and say, hey guys, we just had 100 people at a sellout in New York. And so then we get the gig in a better venue, and we work to filling that up, and we did get 100 people then coming there. So then we go back to New York and say, man, we're selling out, big rooms, and it just, you gotta do that, and then the things actually do build that way, especially if they're being done with quality and integrity of what the actual substance is. The arts is very hard to promote, and so that sort of puffing it up a little bit sometimes is what is required. So, I don't think you need to be a true con artist or bullshitter, but certainly whatever you can do to massage it to help your project, and you got to do what you believe in. I love music, I love wine, I like people. I don't know. I'm a bad musician, right? I like to call myself a professional listener. I don't know a lot about wine, but everyone thinks I'm a connoisseur. I like wine, and I drink a lot of wine, but does it make me an expert? I don't know, but you got to do what you love. And the last part you wanted me to talk about was some of our performers and performances. We've been blessed that I've been able to continue doing what I do. So I came to the City Winery with a Rolodex of 20 years of putting on shows. And once the artists started seeing our stage and how great it was, and the sound system, and we only use Meyer sound, we pay this detail to all of these components of the space, a lot of musicians started coming our way. Last night in Napa, we had Macy Gray. We have Nora Jones in New York. We have just the artists that get to perform in City Winery. I feel so humbled and sometimes nervous meeting them, because these are some of my favorites that I've always listened to. Getting Elvis Costello in the room, or Neil Young to come in and do a short set. These are my heroes, and to have them come in the room is, to me, it's just one of the coolest things that we do, and we're very lucky that we're in this opportunity to see these big names in an intimate space. And so you got to just check our schedule, citywinery.com. You never know what is playing, and hopefully you can get in. Thanks.